David, you're here this morning. And what we've talked about today is really related to your life. And I've tried. It seems like I don't get anywhere. I just keep finding myself in the same spot over and over again. Jesus wants to pull you up out of that spot. He wants to come alongside of you and take your life. And you give your life to him and let him begin to lead your life and guide you in the way that he had planned for you from the very beginning of time. He has a plan for your life. Maybe you're like David, you're out and you've been in the cave, and you've been praying, and you've been feeling chased, and you've been feeling put down. Jesus wants to pull you up out of all of that. If you'll come and take his hand, he'll begin to work in your life. Give him your life, let him begin to live in it. And let him guide every step, every little step. Every big step, every small decision, every big decision, he's there. He might be here this morning calling on you to make a decision. Would you make that decision this morning? Would you give your life to Jesus and say, Lord, I give up. I have tried. And I continue to fail. And I don't want to fail anymore, Lord. Most of all, I want to fail you because you didn't fail me. So would you give your life to Jesus this morning? Would you give him a chance to begin to work? You can come up here, I'll pray with you right here. I'll kneel with you right here and pray with you. You can take a card off the table in the back. Call me and I'll meet with you and I'll pray. You can just find a good, quiet place. And kneel down. And ask Jesus. Jesus began to lead me and show me the way I should go. So that I can give you my life. And he will give you the path. He will give you the direction. He will give you the steps to take, just as he did Nicodemus. When Nicodemus said, what must I do to be saved? You ask him, what must I do to be saved? Because he's waiting on you. He's been waiting your whole life. And he'll wait until you make the decision or until it's too late. Make that decision today. Because the Bible says we have no guarantee of tomorrow. So make that choice. Make a choice for Jesus Christ in your life. Anyone at all? Father, we thank you for today. Lord, we thank you for this time together. We thank you how you just join us in this place and you speak through our spirit. Let us know that faith makes things real. And begin to walk in that faith and that trust and that believing in you. What do we believe in, Lord? Lord, we thank you again for this time. In Jesus' name, amen.